Of Shadow and Light by Emma Chen, read aloud by Yiling Yang. My frantic footsteps echoed in the empty halls as I raced through the crumbling walls again, running, running, trying to outrun myself, I suppose. I had lost track of how long I had spent in the confines of the castle. Every day seemed to blend in with the next, almost dreamlike in haziness. The first few weeks in here, I had cried until I couldn't possibly cry anymore, craving the slightest bit of human touch. Someone to talk to, someone to help me ease the suffocating mass pressing into my chest. But how? I hardly noticed how time slipped by me like a shifting river washing over my head, leaving not a single mark on me. It was so easy not to feel, not to care about the days falling behind me. My hands lit up with captured sunlight as the castle was thrown into sudden darkness, approaching the heart of the place. My summoning had gotten much more honed with all the time I had to practice, but I felt not the faintest sense of accomplishment when I could finally call on my unruly power with ease. It was as though all feeling had leaked out of me, disappeared over the time trickling by, piece by piece. I didn't mind. If I could still feel, it would drive me insane, the amount of pain underneath my surface. I didn't remember the exact shade of his eyes anymore. It had scared me so much the first time I woke up and found that I had forgotten the sensation of the jolt in my stomach every time he turned his gaze on me. Was it easier not to remember? I'm not sure. He's all that I had to hold on to, all that gave me the will to keep going in this forsaken life of mine. Once again, I thought of his smile, startled and shy, his eyes lighting up as he caught sight of me. My chest tightened, and the world tilted before my eyes. Keep it together, I scolded myself, running faster, plunging into the impenetrable, unnatural darkness. In here, evil was brewing, waiting to be unleashed into the land I loved. And so, a golden stream of the purest light danced in my fingers, tearing apart the crushing, almost tangible dark, restoring order for a fraction of a moment as the shapeless evil began to fight back, blackness engulfing me, swallowing me, sapping all the strength from my bones. My knees almost gave out, but I told myself to keep standing, to stay strong against this attack. After all, this did happen every day. I should have been used to it. Everything that I loved had been destroyed by this evil. I unleashed my pain and fury on it, fighting harder every day. I knew that I was slowly losing myself. The memories of before had been imprisoned in the castle, fading away until everything was blurry, detached, like snippets out of someone else's life. I had once found myself staring at the faded paintings for hours on end, talking flatly to a suit of armor and swaying softly into music that nobody could hear. I was going insane, but it didn't matter. Nobody cared anyways. My land depended on me. My people depended on me. Reaching deep inside, a new surge of powerful light exploded out of my body and arched around the heart of the shadows, binding it with the chains of light again. Tomorrow, it would have torn apart the seal. Tomorrow, we will start again. I staggered back, exhausted. Once more, the castle was silent.